Well, here's our tale of the tape, live from San Antonio, Texas, again for the unified welterweight championship of the world. Actually, it's undisputed, even better than unified, undisputed. 37-year-old McCaskill, 5'6", 3 inches shorter than Alma Ibarra, and she'll have a 2-inch reach advantage. Can this Mexican upend the Caskilla?
If she can catch McCaskill coming in, being over-aggressive, she might change the tempo of this fight.
Well, McCaskill said, I feel like I need to knock her out. Boy, she's going for it right away, not wasting any time. Look at the Caskilla, and Ibarra's landing some punches of her own.
Absolutely. I mean, this is just overly aggressive by McCaskill. But like you said, Chris, they have no respect.
Oh, and she caught her with the right hand. That buckled the knees of Ibarra. And you can see Ibarra still trying to shake that off. She's staring up, blinking her eyes. A wild brawling style from Jessica. And again, right up the pipe. She's not letting Ibarra settle in at all. She knows that this is the biggest fight of Ibarra's life.
No, and I love the fact that McCaskill started off so fast, but she does have to be careful. Ibarra has a long, rangy, strong right hand, just like that.
One thing McCaskill said she discovered after her last fight was that her conditioning just wasn't up to the level that she wanted at. So she effectively fired her entire strength and conditioning team and entrusted everything to Rick Ramos, her trainer. She says coming to this fight, she feels a lot stronger.
If you're gonna be that aggressive in Jessica McCaskill, I'd like to see her stab her way into the, in the body, stab her way in before throwing those overhand rights. That way you can get the elbows to block, try to block the jabs of McCaskill.
Yeah, what's gonna happen when Jessica slows down a little bit in some of these later rounds, if she does?
Good uppercut down the inside.
She caught Jessica on the inside with a right uppercut. Still a little bit sloppy.
You know, Ibarra's plan can be to just trade with McCaskill. She knows McCaskill's gonna try to get inside. Let that jab go. We saw a great jab from Raymond Ford in the last fight. Release that jab and fight off it in this round.
Nice right from Jessica. And Ibarra continues to hold on.
Big right hand by McCaskill. I think Ibarra's holding up because she got rocked right there. She felt
caught the again. That right hand has been money for McCaskill.
Yeah, Ibarra's got, she's shook right now.
Everything's under. Every time Ibarra ties up, she's either looking at her corner or looking up at the monitor opposite the ring to look at the clock.
Big left hand, overhand left right there from the southpaw stance from the Caskilla.
Well, Ibarra, I think, saying, you know what? I'm gonna go out on my shield.
Yes, she is. I mean, they're exchanging big leather. That's big shots right there.
Come on, we need a point.
Rick Ramos yelling to take a point, and he's right. Ibarra continues to hold anytime she gets inside.
Well, look, it is a tactic for a bigger fighter to lean on a smaller fighter. Ibarra's got to make sure that in those clinches, McCaskill is carrying her weight as well as her own. Tyson Fury in the heavyweight men's boxing division does it as expertly as anybody.
Oh, yeah. I mean, they teach you that in the gym, and they also teach you not to hold up the weight of a bigger opponent. Take a knee.
Look at Jessica showing more head movement. And then they play Twister.
That's athleticism by McCaskill, and obviously strength. It takes a strong back to have that upper body movement like that. Strong legs.
This is only the second fight for Ibarra in the United States. Her previous one came against Candy Wyatt in August of last year.
And there, Sergio, it feels like exactly what you just said there. McCaskill felt the weight of Ibarra, took the knee, Ibarra goes tumbling to the canvas.
Very smart on McCaskill's part.
Well, this is not aesthetically pleasing, especially from Ibarra's point.
McCaskill just missed a big right hand right there. Ibarra didn't even see it.
Oh, nice shot there from Ibarra. And that just seemed to get Jessica upset.
No, here she goes. It was a left touch.
Here she comes again.
And Tom, this is what you missed right here. Big left hook. Right on the shot right there. You caught Ibarra's punch because the back went towards it. It was McCaskill's left hook. That rocket shook Alba Ibarra. That really hurt her right there.
Don't come out. If you don't want to come out,
what is going on here?
I love. If you don't want to come out, then don't come out. That's it.
And they're waving it off. If you don't, Chris, what is going on?
All right, so I just went over to the corner to try to figure out what was going on between Ibarra and her manager, Hector. And she was yelling at Hector, saying, if Jessica's going to keep holding me like this, I'm not going to fight. I'm going to go home to my kid.
She quit.
The punches that were landing, the aggression, the sheer aggression of McCaskill, the relentlessness, and of course that left hook that bothered and shook Ibarra in that last round.
Well, to say that's disappointing is an understatement. Sergio, she'd been barking at her manager after the first round. From what I saw, I didn't see Jessica holding it all. It was all Ibarra.
I think McCaskill's just she's a monster there. I mean, she's just a mean fighter. I mean, she went all the way across the ring to go. Ibarra didn't get off her stool to come back and fight. Ibarra refused, and yes, Tom, she found a way out.
She quit. I don't know. I mean, she wasn't out of the fight completely. She was landing punches, and you know Jessica couldn't have continued that pace, or at least didn't, you don't think she could continue that pace for 10 rounds. But hey.
She felt McCaskill's left hook, I'm telling you. That left hook that changed the fight right there.
Ladies and gentlemen, referee Guadalupe Garcia calls a halt to this contest on advice of the red corner. The official time of the stoppage, 10 seconds into round number 4. Your winner by TKO, and still the undisputed welterweight champion of the world, Jessica Caskillon McCaskill.